Some prayers for Anzac Day from St. Luke's Anglican Church in Toowoomba. O God, our ruler and guide, in whose hands are the destinies of this and every nation, we give you thanks for the freedoms we enjoy in this land and for those who laid down their lives to defend them. We pray that we and all the people of Australia, gratefully remembering their courage and their sacrifice, may have the grace to live in a spirit of justice, of generosity, and of peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Lord God, help us this day to remember the sacrifice of the first Anzacs, Australian and New Zealander, and the generations of men, women and children who have died in the cause of liberty and peace. Help us to remember those who still bear the physical and mental scars and disabilities of their service. Help us to remember the widows, girlfriends, parents and orphans, and all those who waited in vain for the return of a loved one. Help us to remember the mateship, agony, courage and compassion of war service, but save us from ever glorifying the horror and tragedy of war. Lord God, help us to remember. Amen. You're invited to join in together in singing, God is our strength and refuge. Reading from the scriptures from Psalm 4. Answer me when I call, O God of my right. You gave me room when I was in distress. Be gracious to me and hear my prayer. How long, you people, shall my honour suffer shame? How long will you love vain words and seek after lies? But know that the Lord has set apart the faithful for himself. The Lord hears when I call to him. When you are disturbed, do not sin. Ponder it upon your beds and be silent. Offer right sacrifices and put your trust in the Lord. There are many who say, oh, that we might see some good. Let the light of your face shine on us, O Lord. You have put gladness in my heart, more than when their grain and wine abound. I will both lie down and sleep in peace. For you alone, O Lord, make me lie down in safety. We now have a reading from Matthew's Gospel, which will be read for us by Sandy and Caroline.
Reading from Matthew 5:1-12. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, blessed are the poor in spirit,
for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Blessed are those who mourn,
for they will be comforted.
Blessed are the meek,
for they will inherit the earth.
Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness,
for they will be filled.
Blessed are the merciful,
for they will receive mercy.
Blessed are the pure in heart,
for they will see God.
Blessed are the peacemakers,
for they will be called children of God.
Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake,
for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you,
and utter all kinds of evil against you, you falsely on your account.
Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven.
For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you.
Hear the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gordon Lee is now going to share with us something of what Anzac Day means to him.
Hello, my name is Gordon Lee and I'm a centre warden at St Luke's Church, Toowoomba. I've been asked to explain what Anzac Day means to me. For me, it is a day of sadness, remembering all the lives lost, not only in the Great War to end all wars, which hasn't happened yet, but all wars. I remember not only the lives lost, but the men and women who served and survived the horrors of war and the memories they still hold. But it is also a day I look forward to catching up with my comrades who I served alongside, and we mostly remember this about the good times we had and not try not to mention the bad times. But for many survivors, the war does not end. The war goes on in their minds and they find it hard to adjust to normal life. I volunteered for service and joined the Army in 1968 and was posted to the 3rd Infantry Battalion based in Woodside, South Australia. Most of my platoon buddies were from South Australia, but I was from Sydney, so we lost contact after the war. It wasn't until 40 years later that they found me thanks to Mr. Google, and lo and behold, my name came up attached to St. Luke's Church. At first, they couldn't believe that it was me, but it was. Since then, I've been to a couple of reunions, and it has been a very emotional experience for us all. This year, due to the virus this year, it will not be a normal Anzac Day service, and I feel many servicemen and women will not be able to share the day with their mates and what emotional effects that will have on them. God bless and thank you.
Thank you, Gordon. An affirmation of faith and prayers of confession. We believe in God, creator of the world and of all people, and in Jesus Christ incarnate among us, who died and rose again, and in the Holy Spirit, present with us to guide, strengthen, and comfort. We believe. Lord, help our unbelief. We rejoice in every sign of God's kingdom, in the upholding of human dignity and community, In every expression of love, justice, and reconciliation, in each act of self-giving on behalf of others, in the abundance of God's gifts entrusted to us that all may have enough, in all responsible use of the earth's resources. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. We confess our sin, individual and collective, by silence or action, through the violation of human dignity based on race, class, age, sex, nation, or faith, through the exploitation of people by greed and indifference, through the misuse of power in personal, communal, national, and international life, through the search for security by military and economic forces that threaten human existence, through the use of technology which endangers the earth and all life upon it. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. We commit ourselves individually and as a community to the way of Christ, to take up the cross, to seek abundant life for all humanity, to struggle for peace with justice and freedom, to risk ourselves in faith, hope, and love, praying that God's kingdom may come. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. An act of remembrance and prayer. Let us pray for all who suffer as a result of conflict and ask that God may give us peace. For the servicemen and women who have died in the violence of war, each one remembered by and known to God, may God give peace. For those who love them in death as in life, offering the distress of our grief and the sadness of our loss, may God give peace. For all members of the armed forces who are in danger this day, remembering family, friends, and all who pray for their safe return, may God give peace. For civilian women, children, and men whose lives are disfigured by war or terror, calling to mind in penitence the anger and hatreds of humanity, may God give peace. For peacemakers and peacekeepers who seek to keep this world secure and free, may God give peace. For all Defence Force chaplains offering support, encouragement, acceptance, compassion, and understanding wherever and whenever it is needed, may God give peace. For all who bear the burden and privilege of leadership, political, military, and religious, asking for gifts of wisdom and resolve in the search for reconciliation and peace, may God give peace. As Jesus said to his disciples, "My peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Trouble not your hearts, my peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Be not afraid, my peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Trouble not your hearts, my peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Be not afraid." We read the names of those who are on our First World War Memorial, lighting candles for them and for others. On this Anzac Day, We remember all of those who have died as a result of warfare. Soldiers, combatants, men and women who were caught up in those times of war. Those who have died across the ages, those who have died more recently. We remember those whose names are mentioned in the memorials included within our parish community. That siren reminds us that trauma and tragedy continue still. We remember by name especially those who died during the First World War. Walter Allam, William Brown, Charles Brothers, Charles Dixon, Albert Felgenhauer, Bertram Hartwell, Thomas Hewitt, George Hungerford, William Ingram, Lewis Krieg, Edward Marley, Ned Martin, John Pope, Harold Salmon, William Bauer, Frank Brown, John Deasley, Charles Dunson, George Hammond, Paul Milton, William Hutton, Thomas Holmes, Herbert Kelly, Darcy Maunder, Norman McWaters, Francis Martin, Grainer Raboni, Richard Underwood, and those who we have known, family and friends, relatives, those who have been talked about in the family and remembered and cherished there, and those who have served in many different ways to make our country a safe place to be. For those who have died, rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. Wherever you are, I invite you to stand fast, to hold a moment of silence. the ode. They shall grow not old as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. We will remember them, lest we forget, lest we forget. O God of truth and justice, we hold before you those whose memory we cherish and those whose names we will never know. Help us to lift our eyes above the torment of this broken world and grant us the grace to pray for those who wish us harm. As we honour the past, may we put our faith in your future, for you are the source of life and hope, now and forever. Amen. We join together in the prayer which Jesus taught his friends. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. If you would like to, please join in singing, Great God, Your Spirit Like the Wind.
Thank you.
As and when you are able, go forth into the world in peace. Be of good courage. Hold fast to that which is good. Render to no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the afflicted. Give honour to all. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you and remain with you this day and always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.